them not away from Isaac, both of you, by continuing this litigation. Now, I'm not unmindful of the fact that for the most part, most of these motions are you bringing her to court. But as a practical matter, at the end of the day, you two need to decide what your priorities are. And if your priority is young Isaac, you ought to start living up to it. You know, kids whose parents get along, whether they live together or not, those kids generally, there's always a couple exceptions, but generally they do really, really well. They exceed their parents' expectations because they feel strong and they feel powerful and they feel successful and they don't have to blame themselves because their parents aren't getting along. So, and by the way, for the record, I don't say these things to hear myself talk because at the end of the day, I don't have a voice. But I really try to kind of punch through to the parents what you're doing to your son, because when you two are in any custody dispute, whether it's about money or time or whatever, your child knows that you two aren't getting along and that you're having problems. Okay? He knows to see his dad, he's got to go to grandma's house. Hopefully he loves his grandma, and it's a pleasant experience. But at the end of the day, he knows very well that he's one of those unfortunate kids who have parents who aren't nice to each other. Isn't that special? So, I'd ask that you two start thinking about it. Let's leave the location the way Mr. Page has proposed. I'm fine with that. With regard to talking parents, which is back to the same problem, and one of my expressions that I've started using is, I hope you all realize that talking parents is not parents talking. It's really not. It's just a communication means for parents who don't have the ability to be kind and respectful to each other. We'll go with talking parents. It's free. My marshal will provide you the brochure so you can sign up within the next week. Now, let's talk about the passport. A passport doesn't mean you're leaving. Mr. Ruelas, what's your objection to the passport?
I actually set an appointment when she notified me. I gave her 8 days. I set an appointment in 8 days so we could go to...
So you're going to do that?
Well, no, I did it, but she later, the day prior, before the appointment, she called me and said, oh,
okay.
I can't go.
Can I ask you a question? When do you have to be back at work today?
Huh? I took the whole day off.
Okay. Mr. Page, when does your client have to be back at work today?
When?
It's by the weekend that you like.
I didn't ask you. I asked Mr. Page.
What time do you work today? Yes.
9 to 5.
Do you have to go back to work after this?
Oh, no.
So you're off today?
Yeah.
She's off today.
Have I got a great idea. When you all leave here, you're going to go straight to the passport office together.
Now you got to set an appointment with the post office, mm-hmm. And that's what I did, and I gave her 8 days prior to. I set it for.
No, you don't.
Not anymore.
No, you don't.
And the health district is Merrill Small. It's going
to
be.
Go to the, get the passport done.
So I got to go sit all day with her over there?
Yeah. So that's what you're going to do when you leave here. You're going to go straight to get a passport for your boy. Boom, done. That was easy. And by the way, that was an order. That wasn't a suggestion. So that means when you leave here, you are ordered to go take care of the passport. Okay. Anything left?
We did have a behavioral. It was sort of aspirational, but it might be.
What?
A behavior order.
I don't do behavior orders by fiat. You know that. If he wants to agree to behavior order, that's fine. And you all can draft one, but I don't believe in them. I've said this for almost 15 years. I think they create more mischief than they solve. But if you two all want to come up with a behavior order that you is your deal, I'll sign off on it.
He shook his head no. So.
Nothing in almost 15 years has ever persuaded me that behavior orders are great ideas.
They're more aspirational than anything else.
Well, then that's my point. They're aspirational. If he wants to agree to behavior order because he wants her to behave as well, talk to him about it and you can come up with a behavioral order, but I won't order it unless both parties agree. I simply won't. Now, okay, The last thing you're going to do, Mr. Page, is in the order that you're going to prepare from today. Oh, and by the way, the going to the passport, that's got immediate effect under ADCR 7.50.
I was going to mention
but
that. Thank you.
In the order prepare, I want you to take this financial disclosure form, and I want you to calculate child support and include that in the order. 18% of his gross monthly income up to the presumptive max.
Right now, he lists it being $10 an hour. That seems a bit low given his experience.
Not necessarily.
I mean, there's...
You know, you take a job, you get. If you have some reason to believe that he's lying on his financial disclosure form, he provide you with paycheck stub.
I would ask that at the end of the year, he'd be required to provide his W-2s or his income tax return so we can determine...
Make that another motion.
Another motion?
Yeah. But that's going to be the order. It's based on your $10 an hour, 40 hours a week. Do the calculation, come up with a new, put it in the order. You get to be the bookkeeper, not me. What's
effective
sir?
August 1st?
36 hours, that's what he promised me.
I'm going to put you at 40.
Effective August 1.
$10, so it'll be $400 a week. Do the math. And conclude that in the order. I'm going to make it effective as of September 1. Okay? Prepare the order for my signature, and you two need to get a grip. I'm telling you, you're so asking for trouble. What, sir?
Well, I got a question. Will we do the AM? She is required to answer me, correct?
Oh, yeah, I forgot the other rule. Almost forgot, but thank you. Here's the rule on talking parents. Each of you has an obligation to go on to talking parents at least once a day, no later than 6 p.m. If you go on talking parents and you see that there's a message from the other parent, you have 3 hours after that to respond. Because I don't... one of the problems I'm seeing with this talking parents and our family wizard is people just don't go on it. And then makes the other party crazy because they've been trying to communicate. So it's a daily communication obligation.
Yeah, because I've been having issues trying to get her to answer me when
yeah, she's
going to
have 3 hours after
she
checks. So let's put it this way. The latest she has to respond to you, if you do all the math, is 9 p.m.
This practice is at 6.
She has to check it before 6, and then she has 3 hours to respond. Same applies to you, sir.
Because I have his football pads, so when he goes to practice, I got to go to give him his pads. So I've been, he's missed
the
last
3. I'm not going to solve all the problems in your life. I'm going to issue orders trying to get this case to move forward. Please prepare the order from today, Mr. Page.
I will. I'm looking here. It looks like she responds promptly. So it's a mutual thing as well.
Yes. Of course it is. What's good for the goose is good for the gander. Thank you.
Thank you for your time.